stone crushing to most of you would be new, something different. Avinash will go slide by slide, page by page, step by step, and explain you how it works.
Right. Very good afternoon, everyone. So myself, Avinash Sinha, I am working with Terex. It's around 6 years. I have been in Terex. So why crushing is required altogether? Why we can't use the rock as it is? So if we go into our industry, construction industry, we normally required for road, we require granular subbase, which is GSB, which is normally minus 55 mm. So we want that as a base, then above it, it will be WMM, wet mix macadam, which will have entirely different size than sand, which is normally minus 5 mm or minus 4.75 mm, then plaster sand, which is minus 2.36 mm. So we want to reduce the whole big boulders into this size. For this, crushing is required, not just in aggregate. If we will go in something like iron ore, something like zinc, which normally gets liberated in 300 to 250 microns. So for that also, we will be required crushing, because unless or until we go to that liberation size, which is 300 or 250 micron, we will not be able to use chemicals to liberate, to purify those metals or non-metals, whichever things. Various forces which are which happens inside a crusher. So except the tensile is normally not there in crushers, and remaining all the fives are there. Compression, then impaction, attrition, and shearing will be there in crusher, depending upon what crusher you are using and what is your final product which you want to take out. So crusher, there are basically three, crushing happens in three stages. The first one is called primary. As the name suggests, this is very primary, so you have to reduce your boulder so that you can feed it to your secondary crusher. Then it will be secondary, and then it will be tertiary. So I'll take an example. I'll go through different types of crushers in the coming slides. But the primary crusher are mainly jaw crusher, gyratory type of crusher, which you will be seeing normally into in pit, or when you'll be unloading your truck, unloading your dumpers. So the material which the dumper feeds goes to the primary crusher. Then this primary crusher has a ratio. It can be like 6:1. So you are feeding something like 600 mm. So 80% will be below 100 mm. So that is also reduction ratio is 6:1 for a primary crusher. Then secondary crusher goes like a cone crusher. Sorry, any questions? Right, sorry. So secondary type of crusher, example is cone crusher. And few type of minerals, cone crusher are also used into primary crushing, but the examples are very less. Gyratory crusher, you can tell, is a bigger form of cone crusher. Then tertiary crusher, normally impactors are used. Everyone goes for the machine in an crushing equipment. When there is a plant, everyone goes for crushers. But the heart and soul of any crushing plant is screening. If your screening is not good, let it be the power of crusher which a crusher is using, or whatever TPH it is. If the screening is not proper, you will not get the product. So in screen, there are various type of motion which happens. I'll not go into deep, but each material has a different type of screen which needs to be used. And obviously, if your moisture content is high, then different types of screens are used. Terex normally manufactures screens for aggregates or for iron ore. So in aggregates, we normally give three types of screen. The models are there. 5x18, basically we use 5x14. So that is 5 feet by 14 feet. So this is in general in industry. Every manufacturer we use similar, 5x18 or 6 feet by 20 feet. This is the point where many of your manufacturer will try to trick you. They will, if you want a 300 TPH, TPH is tons per hour, if you want to have a 300 TPH of crusher, what if I just feed below 300 mm to your jaw crusher, smaller fractions basically to your primary crusher. So that will get crushed normally easily as compared to a 700 mm boulder. So that is where they will try to trick you. Many of the manufacturers are, so this all the flow sheet is made in some application which is a simulation. Yes, sorry. Yeah, right. So all this is simulated in a computer application. So if you are trying to feed something which is not possible in your crusher, but there is high pressure from your department maybe, or from your client, that they want more TPH and you don't have machine for that. So people will try to do something manually in the flow sheet, everything is editable. You can do anything manually. The application will just show an error, and people will also try to hide that error. So normally in a manufacturer like Terex or any majority, any MNC, they will not try to do it, but local manufacturers will. The application will just show an error, and people will also try to hide that error. So normally in a manufacturer like Terex or any majority, any MNC, they will not try to do it, but local manufacturers will. So if you are dealing with crusher, I would highly recommend you to please go through the flow sheet so that there is no tricks which are happening here. So the basic is like jaw, then this is a two-stage plant, so jaw, cone, and your final product. So there is new thing which has come up because river mining is banned in most of the parts of India. So all the manufacturers have come up with washing plant. So as the name suggests, washing, we wash the sand. But why do we wash it all together? The reason of washing the sand is it has minus 150 micron. I am talking about manufactured sand as of now. River sand is also washed, but mainly for different reason. So it has 150 microns. So 150 microns particles are which basically in a sand we do not require. The reason is when we are doing plasting or when we are making a structure, and after some time the cracks develop. The reason of that cracks is mainly 150 micron. So if you want to go for a higher concrete strength, then you have to go for a better sand which is washed. As per Indian standard 383 for a zone 2 sand, mainly the microfine, that is 150 micron, should be less than 10% of your total weight. Washing has come up into C&D, construction and demolition wastes also. We are demolishing more and more buildings. Those buildings were once made by, it now also consists some amount of cement, sand, those type of things are also there, still there, and we want to recover that. So for that also we are now using washing. And obviously to remove that, we also employ few types of different types of crusher. With the help of those, we can take out all those steel rods which are there, and the cement particles which are there, and the sand. Basically, we want to liberate sand from it. So thank you everyone.
The treasurer of PCRF, Jaideep Raje sir, can you please come on stage?
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you, sir.